Hello there, Destin over at Camping World. We are standing in front of a 2014 Jayco Melbourne 29D. So it's a Class B Plus model that they offered, 29 foot box with opposing slides and a bedroom slide. We'll start off on the outside here and work our way around. On the door side here, you do have a grill mount so you can do some outdoor cooking. Power awning spans the full length of the coach. And right towards the back here, they have quite a nice little storage area, golf bag, something sort of like that. Outdoor speakers equipped on the coach as well. And we're looking at full body paint throughout, so no decals. It's actually a fully painted service, and it looks pretty good too. We'll get inside in just a minute. E450 chassis on here. You do have your marker cameras, or your side view cameras, I should say. So whenever your blinker hits, you can see what's going on. Slide toppers come standard from the factory, of course, and the shape of this, I really do like the curved slides. It actually looks really, really nice. Hot water heater access on the off-door side, as well as your outdoor shower compartment between the two slide outs. All your water hookups will be right there as well. Generator on board underneath right there. Let's head on into the fun stuff. All right, keyless entry on the coach. And as we walk in, you'll see what the opposing slides really do for us. It does open it up quite a bit with your slides popped open here. Let's start in the driver's cab. So actual leather seats on the front driver's seats, and you do have a leveling system right towards the front here as well. There's our touchscreen radio. And up top is going to be our entertainment right up above there, and a little bit of storage right by the sides, DVD box or something like that if you want to put it up there. Soundbar equipped on the coach. You do have an outlet right by the dinette here as well. And then, of course, our dream dinette, I believe that's what they call them. It will break down to a bed just by locking or unlocking the mechanism right down there and pushing right down. So there's your bed. Then underneath here, get that back up. Should have a little bit of storage underneath. Open this up here, as you can see. And it'll be the same on the other side as well. Opposite from that, you do have a couch pull-out bed as well. And then up above, you have your storage all overhead, and these are on gas struts too, so they'll stay open. I know it's kind of a pain without them. Moving on into the kitchenette area, so you got a three burner cooktop, range hood, and then a convection oven right underneath there. A little bit of storage underneath, and then onto the sink area. So solid surface countertops, you do have the covers that come with it, so it's a two bay sink underneath there. And then you do have the spray faucet that comes out underneath, little sponge hole, and then a pull-out drawer and a nice little spot for a trash can. Moving on down the line, got all of our light controls right here. Main power is going to be right there, and then our awning control as well. We do have a Norcold gas and electric combo fridge. And then our control panel is going to be right next to the kitchen area here. So we have our slide controls, our monitoring panel, and then our generator start right above that. We do have an inverter switch equipped on here as well. Thermostat for the main area is going to be right here. There's our heat. Walk-through bathroom. So we do have a shower stall there. Take that out. There's a little hole for this to go through, so that'll separate out your bedroom and your bathroom if you wanted a little bit of privacy back here. Onto the commode room here, you do have an electric fan up top, foot lever flush toilet, and then underneath here we got more of our light controls, power fan, and then our water heater control is going to be right underneath there. A little bit of storage under the commode sink, and then the medicine cabinet up top does open up for a decent amount of storage there. onto the back end. We do have another little separation curtain if you do want to separate the bedroom and the bath for a little bit more privacy. Bed is on a slide out. You do have two windows on both ends that'll actually open up. Slide control and the lights are going to be right there. And then our thermostat for the back. Again, some good overhead storage up above. And in here, another decent amount of storage for the wardrobes. So good size right there. Same on the other side. And then a couple pull-out drawers here as well. You do have a TV mounted in the bedroom that you can open up for a nice little hidey hole back there. And I think that's about the tour. If I did forget something, don't hesitate to let me know if you got any questions or anything. But this is the Jayco Melbourne 29D, the Class B+. And I hope this helps a little bit. Again, Destin over at Camping World. I'm at 603-452-7291. And before I forget, I'm going to put this on a quick pause. I'm going to get the slides in so you can see what kind of space we'd be working with. And there we have it. Now, standing from the driving quarters, you do have a full walkway. Luckily, you still have full access to your cooktop as well. You can get to your sink. Your fridge is right there, so that's easy access. Of course, the restroom, and goodness, I guess if you really wanted to take a nap while you're driving, the bed is accessible. So I hope that helps out, and again, if I can be of any more assistance, feel free to give me a ring. Thank you.